Second day of May 2017. Always a pleasure to have you tuners. Even as the board continues to resolve some of the issues and dismissing some. Chris, what do we expect to come out of the Jubilee headquarters today?
Well, Akisa, it's a beehive of activities here for the second day at Jubilee headquarters in Pangani. As aspirants and, of course, the incumbent members of parliament, governors, and let's say all elective positions are still trickling in here to hear their petitions or appear before the disputes tribunal of the party. At around 5 p.m., we've been told by the disputes tribunal that they will be releasing the results regarding the Starehe petition. And, of course, Kenyans are still waiting to see who will be given that ticket. Will it be the incumbent member of parliament, Maina Kamanda, or aspirant Charles Njagua? Of course, we'll still be waiting to hear the verdict. Of course, that will be at 5 p.m. Akisa.
All right, Chris, thank you very much. We'll be joining you later on during the program. And, of course, other reporters who are covering a number of issues that are making headlines in the country today, but first let's take a look at the highlights.
Deadline for aspirants wishing to contest the August elections as independent candidates draws near as parties rush to solve nomination disputes. NASA principals are at the coast for a two-day retreat to deliberate on a campaign strategy and program ahead of the August election. And the Asian African Legal Consultative Organization officially begins in Nairobi.
Good afternoon. My name is Akisa Wandera. Many thanks for staying with us. Now, the Jubilee Appeals Tribunal is set to deliver a ruling on the disputed Starehe nominations today. The verdict is likely to set the stage for a face-off between the incumbent Maina Kamanda and celebrated musician Charles Njagua, also known as Jagua, ruling out a repeat exercise. Party Dispute Tribunal has dispensed 170 petitions filed by dissatisfied aspirants, dismissing 70 petitions. Let's go back to our senior political reporter, Chris Thairu, who is at the Jubilee Party headquarters here in Nairobi. Chris, among the famous or the biggest cases expected today are the Starehe, where Maina Kamanda faces off with Charles Njagua. But what are some of the cases we expect to be dealt with today as well?
Well, Akisa, that will be one of the main cases that Kenyans, of course, will be expecting to hear the verdict, since it is a matter that has actually been handled by the party in a way that most Kenyans really be watching on how they will be giving their verdict. Of course, yesterday, the chair of the disputes tribunal, that is Faith Waigwa, initially told us that she won't reveal to us some of the high cases that they have dispensed with, but she just told us the number, it's 170 that they've dispensed with, and they've dismissed 70 petitions, and they still have around 400 petitions to go. Remember, there were more than 500 petitions that they've been launched by different aspirants contesting the nominations that were concluded last week. And I'm joined by the Member of Parliament for All Kalau, that is David. And of course, during your nominations, someone filed a petition disputing your win in All Kalau Parliament, for the All Kalau parliamentary seat. Just tell us what the tribunal has given the verdict, or what has been the outcome.
Yes, my competitor had filed a petition of which personally appeared before the tribunal on 29th in the morning, and he had actually come up with quite a number of grounds, but unfortunately most of the grounds, in fact all of the grounds he had come up with, they were all falsehoods. But I appeared before the tribunal, I countered each and every issue he had brought up. And I do believe the panel of the members of the tribunal, I think there were five or six members, I think they were all lawyers, and I was very confident. Any one particular time, so long as you tell the truth and you present the truth will always prevail. So I presented all the issues I had, And the tribunal had it. They had asked us to come for the results yesterday, but I came this morning and I've received the verdict. And the verdict actually is in my favor, of which they have said I was actually the one who was elected lawfully, that is during the nominations. And in that right, first and foremost, I would like to thank each and every member of All Karau constituency for actually having exercised their constitutional right of coming up or choosing their leader of their choice. And I would want to advise my competitor, in politics, you don't dwell on lies, you don't dwell on propaganda. This is the same person, after the first exercise failed, is the same person who went around the constituency claiming that he had won by a big margin, confusing, and that by itself confused Wananchi. The final day when we went for the second voting, most people are convinced that it is true. He had actually carried the day in the first exercise. And definitely you can see that even affected my number of votes I got in the second exercise.
What were they accusing you of? What are some of these allegations that they were accusing you of?
Some of the allegations, this gentleman was accusing that there are some police stations whereby more than one stream was created, and there were so many streams which were created. That is not me who was saying. We had a presiding officer, we had a returning officer, and that was purely for them to judge. Even the number of people are many, it was for them to judge whether they will create one or two. We have so many other streams which were created in areas whereby even maybe he got more votes than me. But that is one allegation he came up with. The other allegation he came up with, there is a place where people are tear gassed. It is true. I do understand there is somewhere the mob were repulsed because they had to be had 100 meters away from the polling station. But it is just logical, common sense. There is no way the policeman can target, because my people didn't have a uniform, because he was claiming that the police just targeted his agents. And we had my agents, we had his agents, we had the governor's agents, senator's agents, all the MC's agents were all in one room or different rooms. But when someone alleges that his agents were targeted by a tear gas canister, you can see that is something which just requires some bit of common sense to see it is pure lies. The other issue which I found very shocking is someone to claim that in a particular polling station, a certain number of results were announced. Whereas we had the P3 form or something, and the returning officer clearly had that form. It had the correct number of votes which he announced, but this character went to the tribunal giving falsified figures. So most of the issues actually he came up with, claiming that some areas that there was double voting. The issue is, how did he know that there were double voting? And if anything, if there was double voting, how does he know? Maybe if there was double voting, those votes were not for him or for me.
Well, when have they promised to you to give you the certificate, if at all you've now been clear to fly the Jubilee ticket?
I think the issue of the certificate, that's a party official, but I do understand it to be done at one go, most likely on Thursday, or that's on 7th, but we are waiting for that. But I think, at least I have now the clearance, clearly stating that the whole petition has been dismissed. So now we can look forward and start thinking of August, especially now massing votes for the president.
Okay. Thanks a lot, and wish you the best even as you wait for the August the 8th. Well, that has been Member of Parliament for All Kalau, and as you correctly heard, it is that he has won that verdict. The verdict that has come out from the tribunal has been ruled in his favor, and he is assured that now he will be flying the Jubilee ticket come August the 8th. And I'm joined by the Member of Parliament for Nakuru West, and Samuel Arama. Mheshimiwa, kindly tell us what transpired during the Jubilee nomination. We understand that you were flawed.
No, I was not. I won, and I won with the Randa's majority. Mm-hmm. Why I'm here is because my opponents, they ganged together and they came here to say that I didn't win, and the case was done yesterday. I just came to walk around. I don't have any issue.
Have you appeared before the tribunal then? Have you been given that chance to appear before the tribunal?
Yes, I said my advocate yesterday. And I think they finished well. I'm sure everything will be well.
Okay. Mm. Okay, then no thanks. Problem. Okay, well, then we wish all the best. Well, that has been Samuel Arama, and he won, but of course he's facing a petition. Some of the aspirants filed a petition against him, indicating that he didn't actually use the correct ways to win that seat. And Kisa, behave of activities here at the Jubilee headquarters, of course, so many aspirants and incumbent members member of parliament, and however the women for Nyandarua County, Mheshimiwa, have you appeared before the tribunal or have you faced your accusers?
Not yet, but I've placed my appeal. I'm scheduled for tomorrow. I've just come to see what is going on. But I want to say that the few individuals in Jubilee House, the few staffs in Jubilee House want to bring a total mess to Jubilee Party, yet Jubilee intention, Jubilee Party leaders, Jubilee voters and supporters had all the positive intention to vote the candidates and the will of and their wishes to be done.
Okay, we wish you the best, Avian, as you appear before the tribunal. Well, that has been the Women Member of Parliament for Nyandarua County. Akisa, right. Of course, let you give Kenyans some of the news that you have there before you come back to us, even as we wait for 5 p.m. when the disputes tribunal is expected to give that verdict for Starehe constituency. Right. Akisa.
Chris, thank you very much for that. You've heard from a number of the people who've been summoned by the headquarters, probably a replica from all the other cases we have there. But from Jubilee, with the clock ticking for the conclusion of party primaries disputes, anxiety remains high among ODM supporters in Msambweni following the withdrawal of the provincial certificate earlier issued to Msambweni Member of Parliament Suleiman Dori over claims that the exercise was marred with malpractices. The poll result was contested by his closest challenger, Omar Idi Boga, who also claimed to have won. Pressure is now on the National Elections Board of the Orange Party to give a final determination before the expiry of the IEBC timelines. Let's now speak to our Coast Region reporter Francis Ontoma for an update on the same. Francis, thank you for joining us. Residents must be holding their breath there over this particular matter.
He's actually having a huge discussion here regarding who will be flying the parliamentary flag when the August 8 elections will be coming. And of course, it has been a grueling battle down here. Suleiman Dori, the incumbent, has been battling it out with Idi Omar Boga, who is actually the MCA here. But that has been a huge battle down here. And of course, there has been a lot of push and pull here and there. The two have been jostling for this position. The National Elections Board has been blamed severally that it has been silent regarding who actually won in this particular contest. They withdrew the certificate that they had issued earlier. And right now, the statement has been persisting. But what we are having, that is the very latest from this end, but it is, of course, unconfirmed reports. They indicate that Suleiman Dori could have actually been given this particular provisional certificate, and he is actually expected any time from now to be arriving here in Msambweni to be able to arrive here and reach out to his supporters and share the good news. It has not been an easy way coming for him because he says he had won this particular race, but on some technicalities, he was told that he was not actually the winner. But right now, I want to speak with the residents here after this news started trickling in here. Of course, they have a lot to say regarding what this particular matter has been building up. And I'll be engaging one of the residents here. Bwana, tueleze jina lako na kuna habari zinasema kuwa sasa kiongozi wenu ambaye ni Suleiman Dori huenda akawa ndiye amepatiwa cheti. Maoni yako yapi kuhusiana haya?
Kia Mungu, sisi tunashukuru kwamba chama cha ODM kimeweza kuitikia verdict ya wananchi wa Msambweni. Kwa sababu sisi tulipiga kura zetu kwa wingi kumpitisha Suleiman Dori. Kwa hivyo ile ambayo ilikuwa inaendelea ni kitu cha kawaida. Mtu yoyote akubali kushindwa, yoyote lazima ataanza kurusha miguu. Lakini the fact remains, yule ambaye alichaguliwa na wananchi ndiye ambaye atakuwa atarusha bendera. Na tunasema Dori tuko naye pamoja, na madamu chama kimekubali kwamba ule uamuzi wa wananchi ndio ule. Sisi tunamhakikishia mzee Raila kwamba kama tarehe 8 ataona vile tutammiminia kura, kwa sababu tunashukuru tukiongozwa na Suleiman Dori. Sema tena,
tathmini yako ni ipi kuhusiana na uchaguzi huu? Ulikuwa wa haki na huru, hususan katika eneo la Gombato Bongwe. Tunaelezwa kwa kulikuwa na udanganyifu. Kwako maoni yako ni yapi?
Maoni yangu nasema mtu ambaye huwa ni mwoga kawaida huwa na desturi ya kuharibu mambo. Ndugu yangu, bwana Dori, I mean Boga, alipoisi na wakina Manyoa na Zani, walipoisi kwamba huyu kijana kule kule kwake stronghold naonekana pia anashindwa, wakafanya uamuzi wa kipumbavu ule wa kuchoma kura. Kwa hivyo tuasema kwamba kule wananchi walijitokeza kupiga kura, wao ndio ambao waliamua kwenda kuchoma hizo kura. Kwa hivyo hakuna tashwishi.
Asante sana. A very elated resident here of Ukunda giving his views here. Let me capture another view for you here from a lady. Tueleze, kuna habari zinasema kuwa huenda kuwa sasa Hussein Dori amepatiwa cheti cha chama cha ODM. Habari hizi unazipokea vipi?
Kwa majina kamili, mimi naitwa Mwanaidi David Mramba kutoka eneo la Msambweni constituency, Ukunda ward. Habari hizo kweli tulizipata kwa sababu tokea juzi tulikuwa sisi hatuna raha. Wakina mama hatuli, atukai na raha kwa sababu kulikuwa na tashwishi ya kuwa mheshimiwa wetu Suleiman Dori tuliyemchagua kwa njia moja. Wakina mama alijitolea siku hiyo kwa sababu tunampenda, yuko na maendeleo na ndio kiongozi aliye na ubunifu. Tukajitolea na tukawa tuna wasiwasi, lakini kwa kuanzia leo tukapata habari na tukakiona cheti chetu kama mheshimiwa Suleiman Dori amekipata. Kwa hiyo leo kina mama wana furaha, tena furaha zisizo na kifani. Na pia pili, namhakikishia mheshimiwa wetu Raila Omolo Odinga, tuko pamoja naye. Siku ya mwezi wa nane kina mama tutajitolea, tutatoka sote majumbani tukamuunge mkono kiongozi wetu, tumchague kwa tikiti ya ODM kama rais wetu.
Asante sana, asante sana. Of course, a very jubilant crowd there, of course, giving their views regarding this latest news that Suleiman Dori could have been given the certificate by the ODM National Elections Board. Back to you, Akisa.
Francis, thank you very much for that. Francis Ontomo, Coast Region reporter, joining us live from Msambweni. All right, let's now take a short commercial break. Don't go too far. We still have a lot more lined up for you here on KTN News Desk.